Welcome, Jerome. This is an amazing man, schooled in Oxford, cognitive therapist. And so I love to ask these deep thought questions that relate to everyone's life. And so I wanted to ask, if an adult grew up in a home where there was no love, no validation, how can they process through? What do they need to do to be able to process through their life, their thoughts, to begin to see the value that they hold? And then secondly, how can we help someone in their journey to discover their validation?
Okay. Now, generally speaking, somebody who has not received validation and love at home, often as an adult will present with degrees of low mood. Low mood coming from low self-esteem, or low mood coming from lack of self-worth, or a lack of who they are. There's a lack of identity. So in that place, often, as children growing up, often, not everyone does this, that they will start doing things to get that approval. So we call that attention-seeking. Possibly children get punished more for attention-seeking. So they come to believe that if they did A, B, and C, they will get the approval. And they try it out, and sadly, sometimes that works. So it could be, if I worked really hard, if I studied really hard, mom and dad will love me. Or if I keep myself very clean and tidy, mom and dad will love me. Or whatever that achievement is. So it becomes an achievement thing. So there's a conditional achievement. If I did that, I will get love. Maybe they never did, even through all that process. So once they become adults, they have learned an associate learning that if I did this, 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 I will be loved. Or if I did this, 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 I will be liked. Which means that individual has to keep doing to receive love or to be accepted or to be acknowledged. So when somebody is in that place, at some point, it becomes impossible to maintain it. And it becomes a conditional thing. So therefore, they break down at some level of distress to as far as depression, sadly. So in that context, my job as a cognitive therapist is to hold the mirror in the place of what we talked about earlier, about learning and labeling. And what's happened here is this individual has constructed a scheme or a body of knowledge of how to function. So it is always, if I did this, this, this. So then we come back, and that's what we call the approval versus disapproval theme that informs mood. So we then begin to work with the individual to recognize this, that this is what the individual is doing. And to also to recognize how unrealistic it is that our worth or our lives are dependent on other people's approval. If we to be liked, other people have to tell us how we are, rather than finding out things within ourselves, and to be also take some past learning too, whenever that was reinforced, to be able to come to believe those new things and to recognize that it is unrealistic that how many people should approve us before we are all right, or how many people should disapprove us before we are not all right. And recognizing life and its preciousness cannot be evaluated or concluded by other people's opinions. But so I work towards for them to come to recognize if you're a human being, then you deserve the ultimate respect, ultimate honor, ultimate everything that is good and precious, which are part of you, even if experiences have denied that, and how now we can begin to change those perspectives and even begin to change circumstances if need be, and social groups if need be, and seek new context that in line with their new belief systems that will enable and encourage them to be who they are now, not to be given back to, if I'm approved, I'm all right. If I'm disapproved, I'm not all right. But knowing I am all right, I am good as I am. And in that place, if those who want to relate to me, they are my friends who see those things without putting a condition. Those who do not want to relate to me, it is their loss because this is who I am. Now, that's a difficult transition to make, but it is possible to make it because the price paid for remaining in the old system is worse than the price paid to to change the system and to walk afresh.
So I, as a layperson, you know, someone that is not in that professional field, so in that place, how do I help someone when I recognize that their value is in what they do, the value is in their platform, their value is in on how many people know them and, you know, all the affirmation of men. How can I be one to help bring them validation in a way that they could take and receive and embrace that?
One of the most powerful therapeutic tools that I found through the ages, at first I learned it as a therapeutic skill, which is acknowledgement. Uh-huh. So if somebody said, I am sad or I'm upset, I would say something like, you know, that must be very upsetting to you. You know, I hear what you're saying. So just the acknowledgement of emotion. And from there, just coming to a place to acknowledge what they bring to the table. Even simple things like, depending on who you are working with, I would go even basic things and find out different things that they like, what they, you know, what they don't like. So for some young people, it is sports, it is different stars in the musical world, it's just acknowledging that, or fashion, or if it is different cultural groups, even, you know, even things like food and what they represent. And so, for example, some you know, migrant communities will try to maintain home even through food. So even talking about their food and appreciating that food and acknowledging how wonderful it is, there is a sense of the individual feels that they, as individuals, have been acknowledged and their background has been respected. And that gives them a platform to begin to celebrate the things that they have and represent in the normality are good things, and it is good to keep it going, and because you are beginning to celebrate who they are.
That is so good. And really, our heart's desire is to see people come to see how valuable they truly are.
That's right.
Thank you so much.